I thought it would be a good idea to go ahead and give a one-year update, because it was about 1 year ago that we broke ground on our multi-generational 48-foot tall passive ICF house. And so let me give you an idea of just how far we dug down. So right down there, that is about 26 feet. I'm down to the bottom of that. And so we ended up excavating out a pretty large hole, and took a little bit to, I'm gonna go ahead and get that very large hole excavated, and then did the foundation, poured the concrete for that, and started stacking the ICF blocks. And they're a little bit like Legos. I will be the first to admit, it is an exercise in humility doing this DIY style, but it's definitely worth it. One of the reasons why I'm doing it DIY style is this valley that we live in is absolutely gorgeous. It's one of the reasons why I'm thinking about naming this. Actually, my daughter, I think, was the one who came up with the name of Legacy Views. And we just have gorgeous views of the mountains. Can't really quite see them yet, but on the third floor and on the rooftop deck, we'll be able to see those west mountains. But it's a beautiful valley, and unfortunately, it's no longer our little secret. There's a lot of people that are moving in, and it's getting to be way too expensive to live in this valley. So my parents had this piece of property, and they said, why don't you just go ahead and build a multi-generational home? And so we are. But going back to the cost, it's just too expensive to hire it out for somebody else to do. And so I work my day job in the morning, and then come over and work this afterwards, and I'm gonna basically do it 6 days a week. And today being the 4th of July, I have it off, and so working the full day today. A little bit more about the home. We're basically going to have four homes underneath one roof. Our city said that we can only have a total of two kitchens, so that's all that we're doing. So one of the kitchens will be down on the first floor. I did ask them if we could have two of everything, so two stoves, two refrigerators, two sinks, and they said yes. And then here on the second floor, we'll do the same thing. We'll have our second kitchen, but I'll also have two of everything. But we'll be able to set it up in a way so that my wife and I will have, in essence, a three-story townhome over there. My parents will have an aging in place level down on the middle level, and then my two adult kids, if they choose to, and they stay in the valley, they'll be able to have a four bedroom, two and a half bath on both the second and third floor. Both of them will be able to have that. And then if they don't, our city allows family to live here. So that includes nieces and nephews, and just that alone, I've got 30 or 40 of them. So I'm sure, well, we actually already have them lining up wanting to get in. So anyways, a little bit more. Obviously, you can see that we now have the open web floor trusses up here on the second floor. Super excited because the views out of the second floor, we can now start seeing over the tops of the houses around us. Even the views to the east, we're able to see over the top of the house over there. Over here, you'll see that I've got my open web floor trusses for the third floor. So that's going to be about 10 feet above where I'm currently standing. And then on the south end, it's a... The reason why we're doing a kind of a shed roof, so 1.5-12 pitch roof, is so that we can have about 20,000 kilowatts of solar on top of the roof. And because of the pitch, so on that third floor, it'll be about 7 feet on the south side, and then it slopes up to almost 13 feet on the north side. And then we'll also be able to have, on top of that rooftop deck, we'll be able to do like a fire pit and a little Japanese furo. So it's a little Japanese soaking hot tubs. We'll be able to have those up there, and it's just gonna be an amazing place to rest, relax, and enjoy the 360 views around here. So what I'm working on right now is just getting all the walls straightened out. I also want to make sure that this time, because I didn't do it so much on the first floor, I was just super excited to get more of the foam blocks up, because that's kind of how we measure progress. It's a lot easier to measure progress when I'm seeing the walls come up, but I'm realizing that I really need to take the time this time to get everything just dead set on the open web floor trusses. And so I'm getting each one of them individually lasered. We'll get the walls straightened out. And then maybe tomorrow or the next day, probably Saturday, is when I'll be able to start stacking some more block. So anyways, the other update too is this was quite the project, and that was getting the steel beam. That steel beam goes across the garage. And then the first layer of the garage floor is currently in. Underneath that garage floor is a 16-foot tall room that's about 20 feet by 24 feet. And actually, it was my daughter pointed out this morning when we were playing pickleball. She said, "Dad, we're actually going to have two more kitchens because we'll have a little pickleball court down there. The kitchens will be full size. Obviously, we can't do a full size pickleball court, but we'll have full size kitchen, pickleball kitchens down there. Rock climbing wall, basketball, be able to do dance parties. On this side, we'll be able to have a theater, so we'll have a nice big screen. So anyways, if I had to do it over again, I'd definitely do this. It's taking much longer than I anticipated, but that's okay, because these views are worth it. Plus, this will be a home that we'll be able to pass down to. It's a legacy home. That's the other reason why, for the views. Yes, the views are amazing, but it's going to be a legacy home that we'll be able to pass down to generations. And this thing's going to be around for 500, 600, 700 years, because when you're filling it full of 8 inches of concrete and rebar, even though we live in earthquake country, and it being 48 feet tall, it should do, cross my fingers, it should do just fine when that Wasatch Fault rips and we have that 7-point earthquake. So anyways, if you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask. Enjoy interacting, and appreciate you watching, and be sure to like and subscribe, and so you can follow along on the progress on this crazy journey as I build this 48-foot tall passive ICF house. And thanks for watching.